फ्रॉम मानिकलाल मेहता एमपीएस. वेलकम यू ऑल टू द ऑनलाइन लर्निंग क्लास ऑफ ब्रिन मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन. स्टे होम स्टे सेफ. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट. टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज साइंस फेयर. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस लेसन. Okay, students, previously at the science fair in part 1, we have studied that a committee of parents, teachers and students was formed at Vidyavardhini school for organizing science fair. And the themes were, themes means subject or main idea. Themes were first properties of substances, second latest news from the world of science. Third theme was science in our everyday life. Fourth one, food and nutrition. Fifth, plants. Sixth, animals. And seventh one, energy, forms of energy and energy resources. So these were the themes which were finalized for the science fair. We have also seen that the activity for the stalls where they would build and display a model. The students, they can build and display a model. They could give a demonstration. They would present their projects or simply exhibit a collection. We have also seen in our previous lecture about graphic presentations and oral presentations. In short, we will revise this. In graphic presentations, we have seen that students, they can make use of bullet points or bulleted lists. They can use pictures and diagrams and label them right to the point so that a visitor may read a chart or poster at a glance. They can use pictograms, graphs, pie charts, etc. to show numerical data. They have to plan all their posters and charts properly before actually they start making them. We have also seen that they have to make a rough mini copy before they begin their work on the big final poster or chart. They have to check their spellings. Okay, they have to use different colors to highlight important features. This we have seen in our graphic presentations. And in oral presentations, in last lecture, we have seen that the oral presentation or speeches, it should be short and to the point, that is 2 to 3 minutes at the most. Then be confident when you make a presentation. You have to rehearse the speech well, means you have to practice the speech well in advance. You have to be ready to answer relevant questions. Practice doing that with your friends. Okay. We have also seen that we have to wear clean and tidy clothes for the science fair. Then make use of the visuals or graphics in the stall. Okay. Be polite. Be pleasant when you talk to the visitors. And if you don't know the answer to a question, you have to say so. And last but not the least, we have seen that we have to keep a smile on our face at the science fair. Okay, now we are going to learn about more of the science fair in this lesson. Now, after all these preparations, at last the science fair was inaugurated by oldest science teacher, Mr. Gizari. Now, students, here inaugurated means officially started with a special ceremony, and it was inaugurated by oldest science teacher, Mr. Gizari. Okay, it was Mr. Gizari who had come up with the idea of a science fair some 25 years ago. Initially, it was meant for just one class, but the idea had become so popular that now the entire school participated in the science fair. Let us also take a round of the fair to see some of the highlights. The sixth standard children were handling the following stalls. Now we are also going to see what stalls the children of Vidyavardhini school has put up. The first stall was, the stall displayed the water, the model of a water mill, use of kinetic energy. Now, students, you know, kinetic energy, the energy obtained from motion is called kinetic energy. Now, how this water mill, as you can see in this picture, this is a water mill. How this water mill works? A water mill, it works by diverting water from a river or pond to a water wheel, usually along a channel or a pipe. The water's force drives or pushes the blades of the wheel or turbine, which then turns or rotates an axle that drives machinery that is attached to it to do work. So due to the force of the water, the wheel starts moving, and it in turn spins the rotor of a larger generator to produce electricity. So water mill, it can be used to produce electricity or for other works. See, this is actual water mill. This is the picture or image of actual water mill which was used previously. It is very helpful. It can be used to produce electricity also and for also other works. The second stall which was there, it was use of potential energy, a plastic bottle motorboat. Now, potential energy, you know that potential energy means the energy which is stored in an object due to specific state or position of that object, it is called as potential energy. Now, this plastic bottle motorboat, the plastic bottle motorboat, it moves due to the energy which is stored in it. Okay, now you know when, for example, when the spring of a toy is wound and then released, the toy starts playing. So in the same way, the energy which is stored in this plastic bottle motorboat, it moves due to the energy stored in it. So here they have shown how they can make use of potential energy using this plastic bottle motorboat. Next stall we are going to see is of sound. Now see children, this is the stall of a sound. This is a string telephone. A string telephone, it works very much like a landline phone. As you have landline phone at a home, in the same way a string telephone, it works. When you talk into the cup, your voice sends sound waves inside the cup, vibrating the bottom of the cup. The sound waves becomes vibrations inside the second cup, transferring the sound of your voice, and your sound becomes detectable sound in other cups. So you want to learn how to make this string telephone? We will see how to make this your own string telephone. So to make your own string telephone, you will need two plastic or paper cups and a string. Okay, and you will also need a friend to hold the other end of the string telephone. So for this, you have to simply make a small hole in the bottom of both cups and thread your string through the cup and tie a knot to keep the string from pulling back through. That's it. You're all ready to start playing, okay? You take one cup and your friend takes the other, okay? Walk far enough apart to make the string tight. Depending on how long you cut your string will depend on how far you need to stand apart. And also you have to make sure that the string, it is not touching anything else. So when you speak into the cup, it creates sound waves which vibrate the bottom of the cup. The vibrations move along the tight string into the bottom of your friend's cup. When they reach the second cup, when it reaches the second cup, the vibrations are turned back into sound waves. And in this way, your friend is able to hear what you are saying. So this is a very interesting activity. You can also try at home. Next stall which we are going to see is of electrostatic energy. Now, in this activity, when you rub the balloons onto your hair or onto the woolen fabric, it adds electrons to the balloons and it causes the balloon to become negative charged. So we know that like charges, they repel each other. So when two balloons, they are charged, they will move from each other. Means if both are having negative charge, they will move from each other. And we know that opposite charges attract. So if you will bring this charged balloon towards the paper will get attracted towards the charged balloon. So this was a very interesting activity of electrostatic energy, and this stall, it was so popular that additional help was needed to blow balloons as quickly as they were used up. So next stall which we are going to see is food adulteration. Here the parents learned about, parents and visitors, they learned about food adulteration. Now students, what is food adulteration? In order to earn more profits, cheaper substances of low quality are mixed with the foodstuffs. Now these substances are called adulterants, and adding them to foodstuffs is called adulteration of food. Now students, you know in milk, adulterants like water, chemicals like urea or starch, it is added and the milk becomes adulterated. In chili powder, brick powder is added. In rice, small white stones are added. In peanuts, okay, reddish pebble stones are added. So in this way, the food becomes adulterated. Now we are also going to see some activities which are related to food adulteration. So you want to learn how your green peas is adulterated with artificial color. So see what you have to do for that. We will do a small test. You have to take some green peas in a transparent glass. See, this is transparent glass. You have to take some green peas in both the glasses. Then next, you have to add water to it, mix well, and then you have to wait for half an hour. Okay, you add water to it, mix well, then wait for half an hour. Means you have to wait for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, you will observe that unadulterated green peas do not leave any color. Means here green peas, it has not left any color. But in this picture, you can see that green peas adulterated with artificial color, the water turns green. Here the water has turned green. But here the water is very clear. It has not left any color. So this is the good green peas and this is the adulterated one. Okay. So this is your adulterated green peas and this is your unadulterated green peas. Next, we can see, we are going to see, is your iodized salt adulterated? Now, how to find out the iodized salt which we use at our home, whether it is adulterated or not? So again, we will do a small test for it. For that, you have to take a potato and cut it into two pieces. This potato, you have to cut in two pieces. Then next, you have to apply the samples of salt, okay? Different samples of salt you have to apply on the cut surfaces and wait for a minute. That is 60 seconds you have to wait. See, on both the samples, you apply on both the cut surfaces of the potato, apply the samples of salt and wait for 60 seconds. Then next, you have to add 2 drops of lemon juice on both the samples. On both the samples, you add just 2 drops of lemon juice. And after that, what you will observe? You will observe that here we can see that the potato, it has not changed color. And here, adulterated iodized salt, it makes the potato turns blue. Okay, so this one is unadulterated and this one is adulterated. Okay, So this one is your unadulterated iodized salt, because here there is no change in color. And this one is your adulterated iodized salt, because here the potato has turned blue. Next we are going to see, is your honey adulterated? Now how to find out whether our honey is adulterated or not? For this, again we will do a small test. Take some water in a glass. In both the glasses, you take some water. Next, you have to add a few drops of honey to the glass. In both the glasses, you have to add few drops of honey. Now, what you will observe? We can observe here that no dispersion is observed in the glass, and we see that the honey, it has settled at the bottom. Means this one is the good honey. This is unadulterated honey. And here we can see that adulterated honey, it has dispersed in the water. Okay, so in this way you can find out whether your honey is adulterated or not. So students, see, this is unadulterated honey and this one is the adulterated honey. Now next all which we are going to see is of fun with magnets. Now in fun with magnets, visitors, they had queued up to see the different types of magnets at work. Now for this, you can take a mixture of sand, pieces of paper, sawdust, iron filings and pins in a saucer and pass a magnet around the mixture. So we will see that the materials that stick to a magnet are called magnetic materials, and those that do not stick to a magnet, it is called non-magnetic materials. Mostly we will see that if you will do this activity, that iron, nickel, cobalt, etc., it gets attracted to the magnet. So here this was also a very good stall. Next all, see, these are the different types of magnets: bar magnet, horseshoe magnet, cylindrical magnet and magnetic needle. So different activities accordingly can be planned using different types of magnets. Now next all was of maintaining machines. Now in these different children, we can see that the different children, they are holding some posters. So different children, they were playing the roles of different machines. Okay, see, this one, he is having kerosene stove. This one, she is having bicycle. This one is having sewing machines. Okay, so these children are playing the roles of different machines, and they are saying that we can serve you well here. Hey, we too need your attention only if you take care of us. So this means that if we take care of our machines at home, they will give us good service. So whatever machines are there at your home, you have to do the servicing of the machines regularly. Now we will see how you can maintain your sewing machine which is there at your home. Now always keep your sewing machine well oiled. Okay, all dust should be removed from the exposed parts at least once every week, and the important parts of the machines, it should be oiled. So in this way you can maintain the sewing machine which is there at your home. Next we will see bicycle. Now how you can maintain your bicycle which is there at your home? So always you have to keep your tires inflated. Okay, keep the nuts and bolts tight, but don't over tighten them. Make sure that your brakes are adjusted correctly. Okay, then check and change brake pads if necessary. So this was the stall of maintaining machines. Now the fair, it was such a huge success that the school had to run it for 3 days instead of two. Actually, initially the science fair, it was planned only for 2 days, but it was such a huge success that it had to run for 3 days. The principal also allowed the change in the timetable because it was truly an educational activity, because the visitors, the students of the school, they learned new things about science facts and principles. Okay, so no wonder everyone is already looking forward for the next year's fair. Now the very important part of this lesson is the scientific method. This is very important, students, the scientific method. Now what are the steps involved in this scientific method? First one is observation, then second one is research, next one is hypothesis, then next one is experiment, conclusion, and share results. These are the various steps which are involved in the scientific method. Now we are going to learn the scientific method with the help of one example. Okay, see, observe what is around you. So this is the very first step in your scientific method, that is observation. You have to observe whatever is there in your surroundings, and you have to ask questions: why not, how, etc. Now for this I have taken here one example, that why does a fridge magnet stick to the fridge door but not to the kitchen platform? You can ask this question to yourself, that why does a fridge magnet, the magnet of the fridge, why it sticks only to the fridge door and not to the platform of your kitchen? This question you can ask to yourself. Okay, so you might get the answer, maybe it has some special powers. Okay, so next step is, can you think of an explanation? You have to think of an explanation that why a fridge magnet, it is sticking only to the fridge door. So here when we think of an explanation, so this step, it is known as hypothesis in the scientific method. In the scientific method, this step we called it as hypothesis. Now here the word hypothesis means guesses and ideas that are not based on certain knowledge. Hypothesis only are guesses and ideas. Now for our hypothesis, we have to set up an experiment to try out your hypothesis, for trying out your ideas. Okay, for trying out your guesses, whether your guess is right or wrong, whether your idea is right or wrong, we have to set up an experiment for that. So what you can try at home, that I will try to stick it to different things like a wall, a tile, a potato, a wooden table, pots and pans, a plastic bottle, a cup. You can try using the magnet to sticking all the different things which are there at your home. Not only these things, whatever things will be there at your home, you can try sticking to it. Okay. Then after that, what you're going to observe after your experiment, okay, after your hypothesis, after trying out your hypothesis, what you're going to observe, that you have to record your observation in detail. So whatever observation you will record, this will be your data. Okay, and what you're going to record after your observation, that the magnet sticks to some surfaces but not to others. This thing you will come to know by yourself by doing this experiment at home. Okay, at last you have to draw conclusion. You have to come to a conclusion. Do they match your hypothesis? Okay, do they match with your guesses? Do they match with your ideas? If yes, then why? And if not, then why not? So you will come to know that it seems as if some metal objects are attracted to the magnet. They are made of iron or steel. Means only of iron, or either of iron, either of steel objects, they are attracted to magnet. That also, all metal objects are not attracted towards the magnet. Only some of the metal objects, they are attracted towards the magnet. And last but not the least, you have to write down your findings and share them with others. Okay, you have to share your finding with others. Okay, so at last you will come to a conclusion that magnet, it attracts iron, but not all substances. Not all substances magnets gets attracted, and not even all metals. Not even all metals are attracted towards the magnet. So in this way, you can also carry out this scientific method at your home. So students, now I am going to ask you some questions. Who was Mr. Gizare? Your first option is the oldest science teacher, the oldest history teacher, the oldest maths teacher, or the oldest English teacher? What will be your answer?
First, the oldest science teacher.
Very good. My next question is, what was used by the students to display electrostatic energy? And your options are pencils, notebooks, balloons, scale.
What Ma'am, third balloons.
Very good, right answer. Next question, which model was displayed at the stall of use of kinetic energy? Your options are model of solar irrigation, model of water mill, model of water cooler, or model of refrigerator. At the stall of kinetic energy, which model was displayed? Model of solar irrigation, model of water mill. What? Yes, right answer. Model of water mill was displayed at the stall of use of kinetic energy. Very good. The next question is, which activity was displayed at the stall of sound? First, simple television. Second, simple string telephones. Third, sewing machine. Fourth, bicycle. Which activity was going on at the stall of sound?
Second, string telephone. Simple string telephone.
Yes, simple string telephones. Okay, and everyone was enjoying at the stall of the sound. Simple string telephone. This activity, it was displayed at the stall of sound. Very good. So, thank you everyone for your cooperation. We will meet again in our next lecture of English.